My name's Adrian Shergold. I'm the director of Funny Cow. It was made on a wing and a prayer, this film. So to be here and to be recognised and to actually have three viewings at the London Film Festival for us is just, you know, the icing on the cake. So we're very, very pleased to be here. What excited me was Tony Pitts had written the most extraordinary sort of snapshot of this woman, this kid that grows up in the north of England, who wants to be a comedian. And even from the age of 6 or 7, she's funny. And we see her little moments of her life when she's a kid. And then we sort of follow Maxine Peake, who plays Funny Cow when she's older, through a sort of series of short events that take you through her life and how she does actually finally manage to break through and become a comedian, a stand-up. And she's Maxine Peake gives the most extraordinary performance, really quite startling. I think Tony Pitts, the writer, always wanted Maxine to do this, and Funny Cow was something they talked about for a long time. And I think Maxine had talked to Tony about Marty Caine, and that a woman comedian at that time, and was sort of quite obsessed by that character. So she really was always going to play that part and had to play that part. And for me, she's one of the most extraordinary actresses. She suddenly turns things on her head. So you think you're going one way with something and suddenly something else happens, and that's what's special about Maxine. Well, we had Paddy Constantine, who's remarkable, and for me gives the most extraordinary sort of unusual Paddy-type performance. Paddy came on quite late, but when he came on, he just lifted it in a different way. So for me, Paddy was, I always wanted to work with him, and suddenly I had a chance to. And the relationship he had with Maxine was so good. They'd worked together before, so they had a sort of wonderful shortcut about how they were going to do things. And obviously Tony Pitts was in it, who is the writer, which is sometimes difficult, but was fantastic for me. And then Stephen Graham and various other people who just came in and did things. Richard Hawley wrote the music. It was sort of friends of Tony's that he wanted to bring around, and they were all good choices. So for me, it was a fantastic opportunity. And I think it shows in the film that you had a sort of family of people making a film, which they were making with their hearts rather than about money or anything else. It was a real creative process. I think it's one of those films that actually you think you know what you're watching, you think you know it's handleable, but then it keeps on dropping you on the floor practically, and you have to be hauled up again onto your feet to see the next bit. So in a way, for me, I hope it has a powerful impact. It's a funny film, but it's a sad film. It's also a tragedy, and it's also a love story, and it's also about a woman fighting for herself and getting through a system that was very hard to do.